Hey guys, Laura here from What Laura Likes. So I just wanted to make this short video about something really important and something that all Christians know, but sometimes we need to just be reminded of it. And it's that God is everywhere. And that means that you and I can call on Him, like phone our Father with just a thought, with just a prayer. And it is a blessing that I think a lot of us take for granted or don't like fully comprehend. So this video, this very short video, I just wanted to talk a little bit about what occurred to me last night and hopefully to inspire you to realize that God is everywhere and that He is everyone's Father and that we just have this access to Him that is truly amazing. So if that's interesting to you, stay tuned. Hey guys, Laura here from What Laura Likes. So as you know, this is Life with a Catholic Slant. So that's where I'm coming to you. I'm coming to you from a Catholic perspective. But last night I was reading The Imitation of Christ by Thomas A. Kempis. And I know that Protestants also read this book. So this is a great book that can kind of bridge Catholics and Protestants together. And of course it's about the imitation of Christ. And so I'm about 80% through the book. And I don't remember what chapter I was on, but it was something about Jesus being the way, the truth, and the life. And so it was talking about, you know, Him guiding us, and it was so good. And it caused me to kind of lay back and just start talking to God because, you know, that is what we do in our faith. That is what ideally it is when we have a personal relationship with Jesus Christ, is that we, and God the Father, is that we can just sit back and just start talking. I'm also reading Interior Castle by St. Teresa of Avila. And so that is spirituality and the internal interior mansions and, you know, the interior castle coupled with Thomas A. Kempis was a really beautiful combination. And so I was laying there talking to him and all of a sudden it dawned on me how amazing it is that we can talk to God whenever we want to. I was looking around at all of my things in my bedroom, and I was pondering how I hope and pray that I'm not attached to any of it. Even the wedding album, even the baby photos, like if everything burned down, I hope and pray that my relationship with Jesus is in such a place that it would be okay because I still have God. And God forbid, my family could pass away, and I would still have God. I could get locked up in a prison cell and I would still have God. And we have access to God in a way that we don't even have access to with the people we love, right? My husband's at work. I can't just call him and talk to him any time of the day or night. My children need to sleep. I can't wake them up at 2 a.m. to have a conversation with them. But God is available 24/7, the maker of the universe. The maker of the trees out my window and the grass and the sky and the clouds and the squirrels and the whales. The God that created everything is literally at our beck and call 24/7. All it takes is turning our thoughts, turning our hearts to Him. That is incredible. That is just, it should blow your mind. It should be like, what? He's outside of time and place. He's everywhere. That creator is available not just to me 24/7, but to every single human in the entire world. Everybody who is cognizant enough to open their hearts, open their minds, and call upon Him, He's there. And it's just baffling. And it's something where I wish and pray that everybody in the world knew that the Creator, that their Creator, wants them to contact Him. All it takes is a, hey God, it's me, Laura, right? That's all it takes. I'm gonna have to wrap this video up because my children apparently need me. But I just hope that that gave you some kind of pause, that gave you some kind of hope that no matter what is going on in your life, who is disappointing you, how lonely you're feeling, or how what loss you've gone through, your Creator, your God, your Jesus Christ, the person that the being that you should love more than even your spouse and kids is available to you 24/7. So don't neglect that relationship. foster it, call on him multiple times a day. St. Augustine, I just heard this morning, said that we must have a schedule of prayer. We must pray continuously all day. So whether you're doing the liturgy of the hours or something else, like just set those timers on your phone, guys, and pause and just say, thank you, Lord, for this morning. Thank you, Lord, for this meal. Whatever you're doing in those moments, just take that time. So with that, you guys continue to know God, love God, and do God's will, and I will talk to you again very soon. Bye.